I am sad to report that the first deadly volcanic eruption of 2023 just occurred, meaning it produced casualties. As, at 2:54 p.m. local time in Indonesia on December 3rd, the Marapi volcano on the island of Sumatra erupted without any warning beforehand. This explosion threw superheated boulders of rock, lava, and ash over a several hundred meter radius while also sending a plume of ash to a height of 5,900 meters or 19,400 feet. However, since part of the eruption column was much heavier than the surrounding air, the force of gravity caused it to collapse back to the ground and generate a 500 degrees Celsius pyroclastic flow. Within 60 seconds, this pyroclastic flow traveled 3 kilometers to the north and then northwest, incinerating about 0.9 square kilometers of dense forest. 1 centimeter-wide particles of rock known as lapilli from the eruptive plume then began to fall on the town of Bukit Tinggi, 11 kilometers to the northwest. Sadly, at the time, 70 people were actively climbing the Marapi volcano, which is the 10th highest peak on the island, and at the present, at least 11 of those individuals are now confirmed as deceased, presumably due to the pyroclastic flows and ballistic projectiles the eruption created. While the vast majority of those individuals have been accounted for, there are still approximately a dozen people who are still missing, although this total might change by the time this video is published about 24 hours later. What had just occurred was Marapi's largest single eruption in its recorded history, and since a tragedy occurred, many people are likely looking for answers and someone to blame. However, I have an uncomfortable truth. According to my source, there was no negligence on the part of the local disaster agencies, Marapi as a whole was already well monitored, and the equipment on the volcano was working fine. Marapi during the last few weeks produced absolutely nothing notably above its baseline seismicity, ground deformation, gas emissions, or temperatures until all of a sudden the eruption began. In other words, the latest eruption was completely unpredictable with our current technology, with no warning signs missed beforehand, meaning no persons or organizations were to blame. The scary truth is that sometimes volcanoes can just unexpectedly erupt and there is absolutely nothing you can do about it, as volcanoes can occasionally behave in a completely unpredictable manner. While uncommon, if you climb a volcano, there is always a very small but technically possible outcome that it could unexpectedly erupt with no warning signs beforehand. It is a sad reality, but a danger that everyone should know. However, certain volcanoes are more likely to produce unexpected eruptions than others. To name a few similar tragedies, something similar occurred when Colombia's Galeras volcano unexpectedly erupted in 1993, causing casualties among several people, including a team of volcanologists who were actively studying the volcano. However, I feel that a more similar example was the unexpected large phreatic eruption of Japan's Ontake volcano in 2014, which without warning erupted, producing pyroclastic flows that caused dozens of casualties among hikers on what was a volcano at the lowest alert level at the time. In those two aforementioned cases, along with what just occurred, the eruptions appeared to have a major phreatic component to them. In other words, magma in the crust, either in the short or long term, heated overlying rock, which subsequently transferred some of this heat to overlying groundwater. The groundwater then flashed to steam, and since the same massive steam takes up more than 1,000 times the volume of the water it once was, it causes an immense amount of pressure to build. Eventually, this pressure reaches a critical point that it breaks overlying rock, creating a powerful explosion, which in the case of Marapi's latest eruption also ejected some deeper fragments of magma. This entire process can sometimes occur at such a slow rate that it is not detectable with our current technology. Small amounts of ash fell in towns surrounding the Marapi volcano, and since the eruption began, a total of 45 volcanic explosions have occurred. While Marapi technically was at a yellow alert level at the time and had an exclusion zone of 3 kilometers in all directions around its main crater, hikers were regularly allowed to climb the volcano and bypass the exclusion zone. If hiking or climbing Marapi is not completely forbidden after this tragedy, I suggest a similar change to what was made after the 1993 Galeras tragedy in Colombia. Namely, require those that hike or climb Marapi in the future to wear a hard hat and fire-resistant clothing, as well as post numerous signs warning of the now-known danger that an unexpected and unpredictable volcanic eruption could occur without warning.